Okay, so let's get started on actually solving this problem. Again, remember that the first step in our procedure is to extract the complete list of carriers and the complete list of airports from one example page. So what I've done here is downloaded this page, and I'm simply going to parse this page in order to pull out both these lists. So let's take a look at some code. Now, what I like to use for parsing HTML is Beautiful Soup. In particular, we're using Beautiful Soup 4. You can download and install Beautiful Soup on your own machine using any one of a number of different package managers. I like to use pip. If you don't already have Beautiful Soup installed, just Google for installation instructions. Now, what Beautiful Soup gives us the ability to do is parse the document tree, the HTML document tree in this case, and it's similar to element tree for parsing XML. Okay, so let me walk you through how this code works. So what I've done is I've set this up so that it's the options function that does the bulk of the work. I'm calling options, and note that what I'm calling it with is this soup value, and soup is what I get in response to having called beautiful soup on the local file that is a saved copy of this one. In addition, I'm passing this string carrier list. Now, what beautiful soup passed me back was the top level element for this particular HTML document. And then what I can do is I can use the find method here. The meaning of this is find me the first descendant element in this document tree where the ID attribute for the element is carrier list. Okay, so let's go look at the HTML and see why we wrote it that way. Okay, again, I can get to the HTML by using the inspect element feature of Google Chrome. Okay, so here's the carrier list. And note that the ID attribute for this particular element here is carrier list. Okay, so carrier list then will have the HTML element that we just looked at as its value. Then what I'm going to do is call find all on carrier list. Find all does something very similar to what find does. It finds descendants that are option tags or option elements. Now, unlike find, find all will actually find all of the descendants instead of just the first one. Okay? So here what's going to happen is I'll just iterate through them then, and I'm going to just build up a list of all of the values. Now what I'm actually doing here is finding each one of these in turn, and I'm pulling out the value of their value attribute, because it's this value that I need to pass in any subsequent HTTP requests for data having to do with, say, AirTran or Alaska Airlines. So that's how we get the carrier data we need. I use a very similar process. In fact, it's an identical process for getting the full list of airports.